So today I'm going to talk about a high altitude condition in dogs called pulmonary edema. So it is a life-threatening form of non-carcinogenic, which implies that it's a direct or indirect pathological insult. So it's also known as HPE. So the mechanism, edema generally means swelling. So it occurs inside the blood vessels when they seep out into the surrounding tissue. So this is typically caused by constriction. When people get cold, the blood flows towards the vital organs and that constricts to reduce the blood pressure or increase blood pressure. And this can also be induced by lack of oxygen, which is what happens when you go up the mountain. There's a decrease in the oxygen in the air. So the pulmonary edema occurs when the air sacs fill up with excessive fluid that do seep out from the blood vessels in the lung instead of air, and this causes problems with the gas exchange. So for a gas exchange, you have oxygen picked up in the blood and then carbon dioxide dropped off to be taken out and exhaled. So instead of this gas exchange occurring, it's filling up with air. And so what you see is a decrease in space.
Filling up with fluid. You said air before, but it was fluid.
Oh, sorry,
yeah.
Fluid.
That's no problem.
It fills up with the fluid, and that decreases space for gas exchange to occur. And that's when you see a you see the decrease in ability to breathe. So it's caused by improper conditioning or lack of gradual acclimation to high altitudes above 2,500 meters or 8,200 feet. So here I have like a pretty good picture of what happens when you go up mountains.
Yeah.
So for a gradual, like from walking, you see AMS and HACE can occur, and then you see impaired learning and memory the farther up you go, and then you get hallucinations, and then the death zone is up in here as well.
And then, so why would anybody want to go to Mount Everest, the peak? That's the question. Okay.
And then over here we have like why it would happen in an aircraft. So here you have alternate vision, and the limit for aircrafts, I do believe, is right in here. So actually, it's right there. So they're supposed to like maintain that area right there.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And then they get dizziness and tingling, loss of conscious, and then obviously explosions and things like that the farther up you go. And then these are just, you know, different mountains that people do like to climb for whatever reason. So signs and symptoms, you can see here where the lung is filled with fluid, and then you have air in the stomach and large hearts. So the major thing that should register in your brain when you take pets up mountains with you is this panting. If they're panting continuously, that you're getting tired, you can tell that they're not breathing properly. You should take them back down. And I think I have, well, here's another radiograph. So it remains the major cause of death related to high altitude exposure. And there's a high mortality rate without emergency treatment. So for prevention, conditioning, and letting them acclimate slowly to those climb high, like when you go on those hiking trips, and then medical treatment of underlying health issues prior to any sort of hiking trip or anything that's going to cause them difficulty with breathing, and a physical exam and consultation by your veterinarian before and after is probably the biggest thing you want to do, because your veterinarian is going to know whether or not your dog, your cat, whatever you're taking with you can handle that sort of climb. And then some treatments, they do have drugs that you can give to your pets before going up that reduce that pressure that causes that constriction and the fluid to fill because of leakage. But the major form of treatment is to descend to a lower altitude and then administer oxygen and then allow them to rest and to recover a little bit. I think it's all.
Okay. What breed is that on the right hand there?
It's you know? It's like a Caucasian mountain.
Oh, okay, okay. I know it's a Bernese mountain dog on the left there. So,
yeah.
Well, so this what you were talking about reminds me of the exact thing we were talking about last week, the brisket disease in cattle. You know, they have the same thing. They have that pulmonary arterial pressure increases, and it basically drives fluid out into the lungs, which is pulmonary edema.
Yep.
Okay.